Dead Island 2 has just been released. I should probably take a look. Oh, yeah, I bet I can make it myself. I'll be honest with you, last time I played the Dead Island game was when I still peed my bed, so when I was around 15 years old. But I just couldn't miss on this fat, juicy and delicious hype around it. The Dead Island games are cool and all, but let's be real. No one plays them for the deep lore or the intricate storytelling. No, everyone plays them literally for one reason. Dropkicking zombies! To make it more intriguing, I'll try to make the dropkick mechanic in just 1 hour. And that is definitely to intrigue you and not because I can't be bothered to spend more time on it. Anyways, our arena will be the sample high-definition render pipeline scene that Unity provides. And this will be our player character. I have attached a camera to his head and made a simple script that allows me to rotate the player and the camera using my mouse. Look, I even made it so you can see your body. Eat that, Valve! I even have sun shafts! Nice! Next, I added a character controller, which allows me to move the player. It works, the player does move, well, slide actually. Since there are no animations yet, it looks pretty bad, so let's quickly fix this. I've added 4 animations based on the movement directions of the player, forward, backwards, left and right, as well as, of course, the dropkick animation. It looks a little wonky from the third person, but from player's point of view, it looks pretty nice. Also, I'm already halfway through my time, so let's go to the next part, zombies. I have imported another model for the zombies, as well as this idle animation. Currently, you can't interact with them, so I made them ragdolls. They do look even more creepy now. However, I need them to stay straight and go limp only when the player drop kicks them. To make that work, I have an animator attached to the zombies, which controls the movement of that zombie. Once the animator is turned off, the ragdoll takes effect and the movement is then controlled by the ragdoll physics. I then added a collider to the feet of my character, and if during the dropkick it collides with a zombie, it will deactivate the animator on that zombie and apply a force to the rigid body. Lastly, I made some camera effects to make it more cinematic and less nauseating, and here is the final result. I made it so you switch to a third-person camera when dropkicking to make that look cooler. I know, that's not part of the original game, but hey, I'm making my own Dead Island, I can add some features of my own, am I right? Overall, if we ignore the clunkiness, weird animations, bad physics and vomit-inducing camera movements, it's not that bad, especially for just 1 hour project, right? Well, that was a fun little project. Don't you worry, the devlog video on Friday will not get delayed by this. Bye!